Hey everyone, Drew with GeoArm, and I am back to talk to you about the 2GIG GC2e and the programming of the GB1e-345 Glassbreak Detector, encrypted eSeries Glassbreak Detector, that is, into this panel. Very easy, as I say. We're going to go ahead and get this started here. We'll get into security, menu, then we'll go into toolbox. At this point, you're going to enter your installer code, whatever your installer code is. Mine is the factory code of 1561. At this point, go ahead and hit the right arrow down at the bottom right-hand corner of the touchscreen twice. Then you're going to choose the installer toolbox option. At this point, you'll see a few new features pop up on the screen. You want to go ahead and hit system configuration. Now, you'll see Q1, select RF sensor number 1 through 48. So it's going to ask you what sensor number essentially you're wanting to program this into. This is a blank panel for me, so I'm just going to go ahead and leave it on 1. But if you did want to change it to a different sensor, you just use the right and left arrows to change. So I'm on 1 right now. I'm going to go ahead and hit the down arrow to proceed to the next field. It's going to ask for the sensor type. It wants to know what its responsibility is. So this is a glass break detector, so you don't want this typically to be armed 24 hours a day unless you do. If you do, then you would set it up differently than how I'm going to set it up now. But in this case, this is going to only become armed whenever you arm the system to monitor for glass breaking. So I'm going to set that as an O3 perimeter type. Now, if you wanted to monitor that 24 hours a day, you could set it up as a 24-hour auxiliary, and that'll monitor the glass break 24 hours a day. I don't recommend that for a typical installation. So I'm going to set it as O3 perimeter, which is what the typical glass break would be set as. Hit the down arrow. This point, it's going to ask you for the equipment code. So you're going to have to choose the equipment code for this, which in this case is a 2864, which is an eSeries glass break detector for the 2GIG. And once again, that is 2864 for the equipment code. Once you've chosen the 2864, press the down arrow. Now, it wants you to input the serial number. You can input it manually. I'm not going to show you how to do it that way. I'm going to show you how to learn it in so that you know that the system has responded and that they're talking to each other. So we're going to go ahead and hit the shift key at this point. Then we're going to hit the learn button. Now, I've already put the batteries and everything inside of mine here. So once I pop this cover off of it, it should learn in. So we'll go ahead and we'll do that real quick. Okay, now we'll confirm that that is my TX ID, 0241244. That is the correct ID, and then we'll go ahead and we'll get this cover put back on. Okay, put this to the side. I'm gonna hit okay. Now, as long as that is the serial number and it's correct, you're gonna go ahead and hit the down arrow. It'll ask the age of the equipment. It wants to know if it's a new or an existing sensor. It is a new one. I'm gonna hit the down arrow. Now, it wants you to input the loop number for the glass break detector. In this case, it is a loop 1. This thing is going to be programmed as a loop 1. So we'll leave it as that, and we'll hit the down arrow. Now, it wants to know if you want to put a dial delay into this device or not. I don't want an additional delay on top of what the system would already have. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the right arrow and disable that. At that point, I'm going to hit the down arrow, and it's going to ask you to put in your voice descriptor. So at this point, go ahead and hit insert, and then you can use right or left to choose whatever you want it to be. I'm just going to call this one attic. All right, we'll choose the down arrow after we've chosen our name. Now it wants to know if it's going to report to the central station or not. I do want it to report to the central station. For those of you that want to set it up as a local only device, you could press the right arrow to disable it. I don't want to. I'm going to leave it enabled. I'm going to press the down arrow at this point. Wants to know if this sensor is supervised for this field. We do want it supervised because it's going to report whenever it has a low battery condition, it's not getting back to the panel, that kind of thing. So supervision you definitely want. We're going to leave that enabled and press the down arrow. Now it wants to know if you're going to have this sensor chime. Glass break detectors don't chime. They're much like smoke and devices like that. You're not going to set a chime up on this. You just hit the down arrow. Now it'll bring you to the summary of this device. You can press the down arrow and look at all the specs that you've programmed in. There's also a left and right arrow down at the bottom. You can edit this device if you see something that's incorrect. You can choose to edit next, which would bring you to the next sensor. Or you can skip, which will bring you out of this programming field, which is what we want to do here. And then at this point, I'm done programming. I don't want to put anything else in here, so I'm just going to go ahead and hit end. It'll give you a summary of everything that's programmed in the panel. And then there's a back button if you see something you don't like. There's also a save changes with a check mark and a box. So if you don't want to save what you've just done, you can uncheck that, and then you just click exit at that point. If you do want to save it, which I do at this point, I'm going to leave it checked and I'm just going to click exit. Now it'll go through a power cycle. This is perfectly normal. It will do this whenever you program a new sensor in. So we're going to wait for it to come back. And once the device comes back up and we get our touchscreen, I should be able to tamper this and it should tell us on the panel that it's actually learned in. So we'll check it out here. System ready, not armed. Let's tamper it. Okay. And then we'll put the cover back on to make sure that this thing is programmed in correctly. All right. So system ready, not armed. So we're good to go. Ladies and gentlemen, that is how you program in the GB1e-345 into the 2GIG GC2e panel. If you guys have any questions or any comments, please leave them below. Other than that, take care and have a great day.
Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube page and click the Show More tab underneath the video where you can view valuable links pertaining to this product, similar how-to videos, and our low-cost, no-contract alarm monitoring services.